टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न द नेक्स्ट चैप्टर नेम इज प्रोबेबिलिटी. लेट्स सी सम बेसिक टर्मिनोलॉजीज रिलेटेड टू द टॉपिक ऑफ प्रोबेबिलिटी.
फर्स्ट डेफिनेशन इज एक्सपेरिमेंट. व्हाट इज मीन बाय एक्सपेरिमेंट? एनी ऑपरेशन दैट रिजल्ट्स इन वन और मोर आउटकम्स कॉल्ड एज एन एक्सपेरिमेंट. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, सपोज टॉसिंग ए कॉइन एक्सपेरिमेंट. सो व्हाट आर द आउटकम्स? आइदर हेड और टेल. So here the operation having the two outcomes, head or tail, called as the experiment. The next definition is sample space. What is mean by sample space? The set of all possible distinct, that means the different outcomes of an experiment, called as the sample space. Sample space is always denoted by S or omega. Suppose, for example, tossing a coin experiment. So what are the outcomes? So the outcomes are head or tail. So the set of all possible distinct outcomes of an experiment, called as the sample space. Here the H for head and T for tail. So here the set of all possible outcomes of an experiment, here the experiment is tossing a coin experiment, called as the sample space. Sample space is denoted in curly bracket. Okay, now the next is discrete sample space. There are the different types of sample space. So one of each discrete sample space. What is mean by discrete sample space? A sample space containing finite number of points or countably infinite number of sample points, called as the discrete sample space. For example, omega is equal to h comma t. Here the sample space containing only the two sample points, so called as the discrete sample space. And in next example, omega is equal to 1, 2, 3, dash, dash, dash. Here the sample space containing countably but infinite number of sample points, so called as the discrete sample space. So the definition is sample space containing finite or countably infinite number of sample points, called as the discrete sample space. Now the next is finite sample space. A sample space containing finite, here there are the two sample points. A sample space containing finite number of sample points, so called as the finite sample space. Next is countably infinite sample space. A sample space containing countably infinite sample points, called as the countably infinite sample space. For example, suppose omega is equal to 1, 2, 3, dash, dash. Here the sample space containing countably but infinite number of sample points, called as the countably infinite sample space. Now the next is continuous sample space. A sample space containing uncountably infinite number of sample points, called as the continuous sample space. For example, real number between minus 2 to plus 2. There are uncountably infinite number of real numbers between minus 2 to plus 2, so called as the continuous sample space. And continuous sample space is always denoted in open bracket. So here the omega, that is sample space, is minus 2 to plus 2. Okay, now the next example is height of plant between 1 to 2 centimeter. Okay, so there are uncountably infinite number of sample points between 1 to 2, so called as the continuous sample space. Okay, so here the omega is equal to 1 comma 2. So the sample space containing uncountably infinite number of sample points, called as the continuous sample space. Now the next is event. What is mean by event? A finite part of sample space, called as the event. And event is always denoted by capital letters like A, B, dash, dash, etc. For example, suppose omega is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So containing 6 sample points. What is A? A be the event. Event A containing odd numbers. So here the odd numbers are 1, 3, and 5. So here A containing 1, 3, 5 sample points. So this A, that is event, is nothing but the finite part of omega, that is sample space. So A is called as the event. Event is nothing but the finite part of sample space. Next, the types of event. So the first type is elementary event or simple event. What is mean by elementary or simple event? An event containing only the one element, that is one sample point, called as the elementary event or simple event. For example, omega is equal to 1, 2, 3. I am defining the event A containing even number. So here the even number is 2. So A containing only one sample point, that is only one element. So this event A is called as the elementary or simple event. Now the next is impossible event. An event containing no elements called as the impossible event. For example, omega is equal to 1, 3. So A with the event containing even number. So what is the even number? So here the even number is not exist. Here the only the odd numbers are 1 and 3. So here the A event containing no element, that is the empty set, so called as the impossible event. Now the next is sure event or certain event. An event containing all the points of omega called as the sure or certain event. For example, omega is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4. A be the event containing all the even numbers and odd numbers. So here the even numbers are 2 and 4 and the odd numbers are 1 and 3. So here the A containing 1, 2, 3, 4. So these 1, 2, 3, 4 is nothing but the omega. If the an event containing all the points of omegas, then that event is called as the sure or certain event. Then mutually exclusive or disjoint events. So events A and B are defined on sample space omega. Then event A and B are said to be the mutually exclusive if there is the no common element between them. For example, suppose omega is equal to 1, 2, 3. A be the event containing even number. So here the even number is 2. And B be the event containing odd numbers. Here the odd numbers are 1 and 3. So here there is the no common element between A and B. So the A and B are called as the mutually exclusive or disjoint events. Here A intersection B, that intersection means common element. So here the A intersection B is equal to 5, that is empty set. Now the next is exhaustive events. Here events A and B are defined on a sample space omega, then event A and B are said to be the exhaustive event if A union B is equal to omega. Union means combine. Here, for example, omega is equal to 1, 2, 3. A be the event containing even number. So here even number is 2. And B be the event containing odd numbers. Here odd numbers are 1 and 3. So here A union B, that is combine. So combine 1, 2, 3. That means omega. So here the A union B is equal to omega. So A and B events are called as the exhaustive events. Now the next is complement of event A. Let A be the event defined on a sample space omega, then complement of event A containing all the points of omega which are not in A. Complement of event A is always denoted by A dash or AC. For example, omega is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4. A be the event containing even number. So here even numbers are 2 and 4. Then A dash. What is the A dash? A dash means complement of event A containing all the points of omega which are not in A. So the remaining elements are 1 and 3. So A dash is 1 and 3. For example, suppose B be the event containing only one element, 1. Then what is the complement of B? That is B dash means the event B containing, complement of event B containing all the points of omega which are not in B. So the remaining elements are 2, 3, 4. So the complement of event B is 2, 3, 4. So one thing is, remember that event and its complement is always mutually exclusive and exhaustive event. See here, what is A? A is 2 and 4. Then what is A dash? A dash is 1 and 3. So there is no common element between A and A dash, so called as the mutually exclusive. And exhaustive means A and corresponding event union is omega. So here the A union A dash is equal to omega. So combine. So 1, 2, 3, 4. And this 1, 2, 3, 4 is nothing but the omega. So A and A dash is always mutually exclusive and exhaustive event. Now the next is probability. if a random experiment results in mutually exclusive and equally likely outcomes out of which M are favorable to event A, then probability of occurrence of event A is denoted by P of A, and it is given by P of A is equal to number of outcomes favorable to event A divided by total number of outcomes. Number of outcomes favorable to event A is denoted by small n, and total number of outcomes is denoted by small n. So P of A is equal to m divided by n. So for example, suppose omega is equal to 1, 2, 3. Suppose A be the event containing only one element, 1. Then how to calculate the P of A? P of A is calculated as M divided by N. So here M is nothing but the number of outcomes favorable to event A. Here the M value is 1 because A containing only one element. So M value is 1, and N is the total number of outcomes. Here the total number of outcomes is 3. So 1 divided by 3. So here the probability of A is equal to 1 divided by 3. Now the next definition is equally likely events. Events which have the same chances of occurring probability called as the equally likely events. Chance that an event will occur theoretically for equally likely events, it is the number of way event can occur divided by the number of outcomes in this. For example, if you toss a coin, so what are the outcomes? Omega is equal to head, H comma T, H for head, T comma T for tail. Then what is the probability of occurrence of head? So M divided by N. So here the M value is 1. So 1, and total number of outcomes is 2. So 1 divided by 2. And similarly, probability of occurrence of tail is same, 1 divided by 2. Here the event having the same chance of occurring the probability, 1 by 2, 1 by 2. So these events is called as the equally likely events. Now the next is independent events. What is mean by independent events? If the happening of one event is not affected by the happening of one or more event called as the independent events. Or another definition is probability of A intersection B is equal to probability of A into probability of B. Now the next is addition theorem of probability. So what is the addition theorem of probability? Probability of A union B is equal to probability of A plus probability of B minus probability of A intersection B. So in our syllabus, only the statement is there. So the next is multiplication theorem of probability. So the multiplication theorem of probability is probability of A intersection B is equal to probability of A given B into probability of B, or probability of B given A is equal to probability of A. So here the probability of A given B and probability of B given E are the conditional probabilities. Thank you.